This is Christopher with AG Productions. Welcome to another edition of Watch Me Work on Azrael. We're going to continue working on the feathery wing areas of the miniature today. Last time, depending on when these videos get uploaded, last time we worked on the little wings on this central sort of chest eagle style piece here, and now we're going to do these. 5 minutes later for me, but a week or so later for you guys. I've got my color mixed up here, my first highlight color, and I'm hoping that this one will move a little bit more swiftly because the wing pieces or the wing detail is a little bit bigger on this particular piece of detail than it was on the chest wings. So, we'll see what happens, but I'm thinking that this might go a little bit more swiftly. Still utilizing my Winsor & Newton 000 brush. Whoa, hello. Well, that's not good at all. You see that white spot there? Gotta be careful. Alright, so, the paint I was using has already dried. So what we'll do is we'll just kind of come in, kind of hit it with the brush and a little bit of water until we just sort of scrub it off. All right, maybe even use our finger now a little bit. Maybe a gentle, and I do mean gentle, fingernail. Almost off. Is we'll touch up that area real quickly with a little bit of dark green. Let me just put a little bit of this on the palette. I can get some actual color instead of just paint medium. Alright, let's do this. Mostly paint medium, how exciting. That's okay. A little color in there, not much, but some. I'll let that dry for a moment. We'll see how it looks in a few minutes once it's dry, and then we'll come back in and maybe put a little bit more green in that area. But for now, let's get back to that set of wings there. I'll be a little bit more careful now, though. Don't want to go back and start repainting a lot of green stuff. So, a little more slowly, more methodically, and make sure that we pay close attention to what we're doing. Again, I want to apologize if the sound of my heater kind of distracts you. Hope I can edit it out. I have been able to several times before. Sometimes it doesn't like to go away, though. So, we'll see what happens. Alright. Now, the upper layer of wings, at least on this side, I don't know about the other side, is not as well defined, and so it's going to be a little bit more difficult for me to get to them. But I'm going to use the same technique that I used when I did chest, which is sort of holding it in such a way that the light kind of catches what I'm supposed to be painting and what I'm not supposed to be painting. And for the stuff that I can't tell, we'll just make it up. I apologize if I go kind of quiet here. I'm really having to focus to make sure that the paint gets right in exactly the spots that I want it to go into. And preferably nowhere else. There we go. So using that light really, really helps.
A lot.
Just kind of going back on that lower level, making sure everything has been touched. Now, there's a little kind of discrepancy here on where the wing begins and ends on the outer layer. I think I've got it figured out, and we're going to do it like I think it's going to work. But if it doesn't work that way, then, hey, we'll come back and we'll do it again, right? That's one of the keys for painting your miniatures and getting good results. If you don't like what you see, do it again. I know we don't like to do that as a society. As a people, we think, well, gosh, I just finished it, but I really don't want to have to do it again. It's extra work. But if it's going to make it look better the second time around, and if it kind of bugs you because it doesn't look right, just take some time and fix it. You'll feel better. Got some paint here ready to go. Gently pull down the side over here. Now, I probably shouldn't even worry about the back here. In fact, this whole side of the this wing is probably going to get covered up by the backpack, but just in case, I want to make sure that I cover it up anyway. Now, while I'm thinking about it, let's go ahead and hit that green area again. And I'm just going to take some paint. Sometimes with these Vallejo containers, you can see the paint sort of cakes up around the nozzle. So I'm just going to grab some from right off there and put it on my palette instead of squeezing some out the tip. Don't need to do that. It just sort of builds up sometime. I'm just going to use that. Got just a hint on my brush here. Use just a little bit of that to cover up that area right there, and then kind of dab it with my finger, and a little finger dab, if you do the technique right, helps to blend stuff in nicely. Alright. I think we got a little bit more of this light blue color in some areas that we don't want it, but I'm not 100% sure yet. I think some of it may be dust. So I'll dust this section off in a few moments. But what I want to do is I want to get done with the alternate side of this set of wings before I do any major cleanup. And for this one, pretty much the whole thing, I'm going to have to utilize my table lighting to highlight correctly. Because it's very, very, very shallow sculpting. But the light really brings it out. There we go. Missed the discussion during the last video. One of the things I talked about was in painting fine detail like this, I tend to use a very thick paint. You can probably see, perhaps, assuming I'm in the frame. Hey, cool, I am. You can probably see there's a lot of, like, sort of gloppiness on my brush. And that's because when I'm dealing with fine detail like this, I've found that if I use a thin paint, like I would normally utilize for the rest of a miniature, say for instance the armor of the model, that was very, very thin paint I was using. If I do that for something like this, in very fine detail, especially with very shallow detail, as this wing set has, I found the paint tends to sort of sink into the cracks and crevices and ruin the detail. It doesn't necessarily ruin the detail, excuse me. It gets into the detail where it's not supposed to be. And I want to prevent that from happening as much as possible. So, I like to use nice thick paint on these fine detail areas, because I know I can just sort of glop it on and it's not going to run anywhere that I don't want it to. Anywhere that it goes is my fault. It's sort of like, it'd be almost like switching from watercolor paints to oil paints in the middle of a piece. Which you could do, I'm sure. But, I think it helps. For me, again, personal opinion. And I paint differently than everybody else does. And, well, not everybody else. I'm sure there's some people out there that paint in a very similar manner to myself. But for the most part, I do have a different style than a lot of other people. But I guess what I meant by that statement was everybody sort of has their own style. And everybody has a style that they enjoy utilizing. Alright, got a little bit more here. Got one major area. And that should just about wrap this highlight up. There we go. Okay. Now, I want to take a little bit more of that green, just some very, very, very gentle strokes, and come down here. There we go. All right, that was excellent. Great use of that. Now I'm curious if this is a piece of dust. It is not. It is actually a little bit of paint. So. Or it's a very, very, very dry piece of dust. I don't know. But we're going to cover it up with just a little bit of this green. And that way it won't matter. Alright. A little bit of this green back here in the back as well. All I'm doing is kind of cleaning up this this set of wings. That's all I'm doing. Clean up the bottom down here as well. Bit more water in the brush here. A tiny bit more paint. There we go. Excellent. Cleans up nicely. I need to clean the top up just a little bit, but I'll wait until after I get the white highlight on here, which I need some white paint again. Let's get some of that. And we'll get this guy rolling. We are just about done with this section of the model. Probably going to paint the little hooded figures next, just to add a little extra color. I still don't know what color to paint him, though. I know both of the swords are going to be a nice reddish color. I can visualize, but the little figure in the center of the chest, I don't know. Maybe a gold. No. That might not work well with the white, but it might be kind of interesting looking. We'll see. So next video may end up being a little bit of an experimentation video to see what colors are going to work well. Excellent. You can see I'm using basically a...
Oh, that was really good. Oh, no. I saw the peg here. I was looking at my camera, and I thought I just went over the shoulder pad over here with this white. But you can see I've got this big ball of paint on the end of my brush, and that's kind of what I mean when I say I'm using thicker paint. I'm just sort of placing the tip of that ball on the detail and kind of pulling. And as I do, you just sort of leave some of that paint behind. I wouldn't advise painting like this. It's a rather odd method, and it's not very neat and tidy, and it doesn't necessarily yield the best results, but it does give me a fair amount of control when dealing with these fine details. Bit more water and a little more paint. Getting quite chilly sitting here. I may end up having to cut my heater up to a higher level before I do the next video. And I don't know. Ooh, little hair on the miniature there. Come on. Come off. Damn it. There it is. Alright, great. That's one bad thing about utilizing a paper towel as your drying tool for whenever you rinse your brush out. Tends to leave small hairs in the brush, which can then transfer themselves onto the miniature. They make these things, they're called lintless towels. I've heard that they're very good. Never used one, wouldn't know where to buy one, but you can try one out if you want. It's not supposed to leave any strings in your brushes or anything like that. This piece here. Go. Okay, so that half is finished. Let's take a look at it real quick. See if I can kill some of the light so you guys can see some of the detail. Oh yeah, that much, much better. There we go. That stands out really nicely against that dark green. I think that's going to show up very well. It's going to look really nice. Alright, let's get some more paint and do the other side. We'll call it a video. Alright, where are we? Oh my, this one is it's taking a little bit longer than the last one. I thought it was going to go faster. I was wrong.
Maybe if you'd stop talking, Christopher, and just paint it.
Yes, I know. Keep flapping my big mouth.
faster than the other side. Alright, let's do the final stretch and call it a day. Couple more areas and we'll be done. There we go. And then one more, a big outer wing piece. And then I may have to do a little cleanup work, hopefully not though. Kind of get the outside edge of this. There we go. And there's just one little more area and we're done. Except for some cleanup, like I said. A little green cleanup on the top here that I see. But nothing major, which is great. Now, just need to play cleanup for a moment, and we'll call it a day. A little bit longer video than the last one. That's all right, though. Hopefully, you found it enjoyable. All right. A little water, a little paint, and let's play cleanup. After I pull the hair off my brush. There we go. Going? Yeah. Just gently want to touch. The corner areas up here where the wings meet the shoulder pauldron. Other side is pretty good looking, so I think we're basically good to go. I want to clean this area up right here where the sword is, just slightly, kind of help delineate it once again. Maybe a little bit in this area here. See anything else glaring that needs to be cleaned up, so I think we'll call that done. Very, very nice. I like it. Oh, well, you know what? It was done until I threw the miniature away. Honestly, let's see here. Got a little damage there on one feather that I see, so let's take a little bit more white, fix that.
I tend to do that a lot. I don't know why. It's clumsiness, I suppose. Got a piece of dried paint sort of hanging off the feather there. There we go. Alright, maybe a little bit up here. Well, for the most part, seems fairly unharmed, which is good. Alright, so now what I'll do is move on, and I think the next thing we'll do is paint this fella here right in the center of the chest, the sword, and then the sword over here on this shoulder pauldron. So, that's all I got for you guys today. I hope that you've enjoyed this episode of Watch Me Work on Azrael. If you have any comments or questions, feel free to drop those down in the comment section down below. Also, be sure to leave a thumbs up on this video and subscribe to AG Productions if you have not done so already. Again, I want to thank you very, very much for watching. God bless you all. Have a phenomenal rest of the day, and I will see you all in the next video.